Life is short. Here's how to spend it wisely.
Look, any weapon formed against me can't prosper. Imposter, I'ma fill him with lead. My best friend like Tommy Lee Sparta, I'm in the Gaza just trying to get...
You know, back 2 years ago, I would never thought that I would be hanging out with guys that resonate on your frequency. You're with the right crowd of people and be working on something that's important to you. You know, building social circles, building tribes, being around high-level guys, high-value dudes, and just genuinely enjoying life and not just sacrificing now in order to get a better future now, but actually living now and getting a better future later. If you don't have that tribe of people around you, don't have the circle of people around you, it's all about finding or hosting that weekly thing where people can come together, get together, and just have human connection. You know, me, Jackson, Will, you know, Alex, Luke, we're all starting this thing where every single week, every single Friday, guys who resonate with the same on the same frequency, on the same mentality, they're into personal development, who want to grow, who want to achieve big things. We all come together on Friday morning because all the wages work 9 to 5 on Friday, so we can filter them out. But besides them, we start to attract like-minded people when you host these things, when you host events which resonate with these people. So boxing, that's quite a masculine thing to do. You know, guys who are into personal development, improving themselves, who want to be more masculine, who want to be more stronger. This is sort of the people that you attract when you host events like this. So if you want to build that tribe of people, you need to have traffic and inflow coming into your circle, coming into your life. And the best way that you can do that is hosting these container events or finding an event that someone else is hosting and bring people together. You know, me, Will, Jackson, we all hosted this thing. I didn't start this thing. Maybe Jackson also started it, but then we all started it together as a trio, right? Then after this event, we had this event. Then I started to invite other people. Luke, I put on my story. Luke reached out to me. I messaged Alex. Alex reached out to me. And then there's more people come. And then they invite more people. And then more people come. And it starts to skyrocket. It starts to snowball. So when you have just one event running every single week where you can invite a couple of people to, everything starts snowballing. When there's an intention, there's a purpose behind the event, which is this event is to have like-minded people to come together, to exchange ideas, to improve themselves, to make more money, to grow in relationships, their physical health, everything.
People talk about like why school can be so fun, or high school or university. It's because like the brotherhood, like high school football or whatever. We crave that. That's like, that's war. That's all the things we love, is like a team kind of with the boys.
Yeah.
It's a bit fucked because that's after school. There's none of that. There's no brotherhood. So it's like you become very reliant on like institutions and school and university to have that sense of community, because there's like a lack of it right now. So I think that's also why a lot of these, you know, pop-up communities are happening around Perth, where you have Cold Nips, you have Polarize, you got the Evolve. You have all these different small communities, run clubs as well, open up because people crave that human connection. It's something that people are lacking nowadays, because you either go to work, you play video games, you go on social media, and that's like your squad, that's like your human connection.
They want us split. We're monkey together strong. If we stick together, we can really make some change. And it's funny, but it's like true, that people above us make the rules. They want us to be fighting, arguing, not united, strong, together. In high school, they tell you it's like, well, in all education, it's by yourself, it's alone, no cheating. But in the real world, if you get boys together, you can really, a business together or some sort of fitness, it's like you're much stronger together. Everyone has their strengths.
Isn't that like weird that you have the mindset that if you ask someone else for help, or you get like the cheat codes, or you get the answers from someone else, that's somehow cheating? They actually just like instill that programming that if you get someone else for help, that's like you're breaking the rules. Isn't that fucked? Like, you actually asking for help is cheating. Like, what's the answers for this test? You know a guy that's really smart right next to you. He knows the answers for all of math, but you know all the answers for English. You ask him for the math question. Yo, what's the answer for this? That's kind of cheating. But in the real world, that happens where you're good at sales, I'm good at marketing. Okay, you deal with the sales, I deal with the marketing. That's not cheating.
No.
That's fucked, isn't it? So it's like, they don't want you to be able to think critically, even though they say, oh, like, you need to, when you do English assignments, when you do stuff, you need to have critical thinking. Yet they don't actually help you develop critical thinking.
When your dopamine receptors aren't fried, this is like the funnest shit ever. We're literally just sitting out in the sun, you know, just talking with a mate. We just punch each other for like an hour, getting the vitamin D, like kicking a ball around. This is it. This is the peak fun. You give us both $10 million, we would still be like, we might be somewhere else, freaking yeah. Puerto Rico or something, but we'd still be just like, same shit. This is chilling. What life's all about, really.
Yeah.
And you just want to get a business that you can kind of vehicle it to take you that place. But really, it's just like, we made it right now. We're going to be looking back on this. This is it.
Yeah.
This is sick.
Like I know a lot of you guys are like maybe focused on money, or like you guys already got the money, and like you think that more money will make everything better, but it actually won't. You need that network around you, need that support, that circle around you. So whenever you like feel bad or feel shit, like you have people that they're able to see externally what's happening around you that you aren't able to see, because your like self-perception on like how everything is going is quite biased, you know? You're not able to see things how they are, but when you have someone around you, they're able to see what's actually happening. With the girls, business, right? You're able to see what's happening. They're able to give you that outsider perspective. This is reality. This is the game that you're playing. And you can design your character in the way that you want to. Now, of course, you were dropped here with random characteristics. So I was born Asian. I can't just be black the next day. I can't choose to be African and just switch my skin color unless I dye myself, but I'm still Asian inside, right? You can't change your skin color. You're dropped down with random characteristics. So you have to play with the cards that you're dealt. And you guys may think, I don't know, all the black pillars may think that, oh, it's like, if you're Asian and if you're Indian, you're fucked. You can't get girls. I'm like, no, that's not true. I know a guy who's like 5'3". He's one of my friend's friend, right? He's 5'3", he's jacked, but he's like really fucking good with girls. And he's short, but he's shredded, bro. And he's like, it's an excuse, bro. It's an excuse. So you need to play with the cards that you're dealt, because what other option do you have? If you're I'm a 5'6 Asian, that's apparently short, right? 5'6, 5'7 Asian, I'm a 5'7 Asian and I'm short. Am I just gonna give up? You can choose to play the game of life and just do the best that you can. Get dressed nicer, get a bit more fitter, improve your social skills, improve your money, become a bit more well-rounded. And like there is no other option. You either improve or you just stay where you are or decline. Like, I don't know, do you see any other option?
Yeah, I feel like focus on what you can control. If you can't control it, just don't mention it ever again.
If you focus on what you don't want, you're going to be stressed out. And if you focus on what you want, you're going to be motivated. So stop focusing on what you can't change, because you're just going to keep getting stressed out. And focus on what you can change. Focus on what you want, what you desire. And you're going to feel extra motivated, because like, oh shit, like this money I'm going to get, the amount of traction I'm going to get, the amount of confidence, the amount of progress I'm going to make. If you focus on what you want, you're going to be more motivated than if you focus on what you don't want. You're going to be a bit more stressed and way more stressed out, because you're focused on the negative here instead of the positive. So it's like that prayer, I think, in God. There was one thing called the serenity prayer where it said that God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. So you need to be able to just like see the difference between what you can control and what you can't control. So then whatever you can control, have the courage, take the action to change it. And what you can't control, accept it and just move on. And that will like get you like peace, and you just feel more better in life. Do you want to join in?
Sure. Bro, this is insane. I like how you could memorize a Bible verse.
Yeah.
That's fucking good stuff.
What do you have to say?
Life is too short, huh?
Yes, it is.
And as you get older, it's going to feel shorter, too. You know how that works?
Yeah. Explain it. Hold it.
Because time is relative to how long you've actually lived. The longer you live, the quicker time passes. So you think, I'm only 18 years old, oh, I've got plenty of time. Actually, no, you don't. Because by the time you're 23, things are going to be moving a lot faster. Especially as a man, you're going to be stacking liabilities the older you get. So when you're 18, it's a time to act. Alex Hormozy says, you have nothing to lose. So that means you have endless shots on goal, especially when you're younger. So you should be most prone to taking action when you're young. Because especially people I know, once they get to 25, they accidentally have a kid, or now they have a wife. You know what I mean?
As you live longer, the way you perceive time, it starts to become shorter, because when you were 5, right, and then the 1 year passed and you turn 6, you felt that 1 year was really long, because that's 1/6 of your life, bro. Like, you're 5 years old, you turn 6, 1 year's passed, that's 1/6 of your life. However, if you're like 50 years old, 1 year's passed, that's 1/50th of your life. The way you perceive it is going to be 100% differently from when you were 6 years old. So as you age more, you perceive time, like, it passes by faster, because there's like more time you've experienced it, because you said time is relative, right? So you experience time more faster the more you age. So every year that's passing by will pass faster and faster and faster. And so you just have to realize that the only thing that you can do is to act now, act with speed. This is the first lesson in Hustlers University. True. Act with speed, right? Because time is running out. And I'm not saying that out of urgency, because I know people say that as like marketing and sales, where they say time is running out, buy this, buy that. But truly, genuinely, time is running out, and you could die the next day. I almost died a week ago. I almost hit a car, like crashed into a tree. It was 2 a.m. and I was driving home, right? And I drifted on the curb and I almost fucking slammed to a tree, 70 kilometers an hour.
Time, right?
Yeah, I almost died 3 times last week. It's crazy. I almost crashed 3 times. I'm not even joking. Like, don't laugh. I'm actually like being serious. So I could have died and not accomplished what I wanted. Just like you, just telling you guys that you could die any minute. Tomorrow, a Volvo bus could just go around and fucking swerve you, knock you out, your neck cracked, you're just fucked, right? That could happen. So there is no guarantees in life. Don't like fuck the guarantees, whether you buy anything. Fuck the, I'm gonna guarantee you $1 million. There is no guarantees in life. There is no guarantees whether you live, whether you get this a thing. All you have to do is work hard, work to the best of your ability, act with speed, do everything you can to achieve what you want, because time is running out and every year that passes by is getting shorter and shorter and shorter. The way you perceive time is going to pass by faster and faster, faster. No matter if you're 10, you're 15, you're 20, you're 25, you're 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, whatever age you are, it's passing by very, very fucking fast.
If you think back to when you were a kid, even waiting for 30 minutes to pass for you to go to school, it felt like forever, right?
Yeah.
When you're a kid, things move slow. Well, how about that 1 hour test you did when you were in, I don't know, year 10? Just felt like forever.
Yeah.
Didn't it? But now it's like 1 hour, just blink, gone. Because you're not. You look at the clock one time, look at it again.
You're not able to like gauge how much that time actually is until you're a bit older and you're able to compare.
Yeah.
Because you experienced 20 years and you're able to see, okay, that 1 minute is not as big as I thought because I lived that 20 years. But because when you're 10 years old, that 1 minute is a little bit longer because of the amount of time you lived and you're able to see how long that is. So it's just like, sure, that's really interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's dope.
But also, boys, if you're working when other people aren't working, you got double time. Out of 10 people, if none of them are doing anything and you're the only one doing it, it's like stacked. It's like double XP. You can make lots of progress. You guys are going to be doing stuff. Start today to do something because tomorrow, like they said, is not guaranteed.
It's not guaranteed.
So take some action today. That's the only way you can guarantee some results, is if you're doing something today.
Oh man, every single person I talk to, if they work a 9-to-5, they get home and they're like, I don't want to do anything else, I've been working all day.
Bro, I think it's lazy to stop there.
Yeah.
I 100% think it's lazy because everyone else stops there, right? Everyone stops there, drinks a beer, watches TV, who knows? But like you said, if you work in that time, it's worth extra because no one else is.
Yeah.
Bro, I did that when I was, a year ago when I was on my, working at a dealership as a trainee salesman. Bro, I'd get home, and no joke, I'd get home at 5:30 p.m. or 5:40 p.m. First thing I'd do is, I wouldn't have a shower, I'd get changed, put on my work gear, and I would start working on my four-wheel drives, because that's how I was making money at the time.
Yeah.
And I'm not kidding, I would work from 5:30 till like 9:30 p.m. when it was fully dark, I had all lights set up, and I'd work every single day. Bro, everyone thought I was fucking crazy. Everyone was like, what is wrong with this kid?
Yeah.
But in my mind, I'm like, this is the only thing I know what to do right now that's going to at least move me forward. And it's like, I guess the main excuse is, oh, I don't know what to do. I'm sure you guys have been there. Oh, I don't know what to do. You sort of have that urge, like, I want to do something more, but you don't know what to do. Just don't worry about the information. That will come as you keep pushing forward. What matters now is that you're taking action and doing. So, bro, it was not making a lot of money, you know? It'd make like $1,000 every 2 weeks, but I was doing something.
And you were learning.
And I was learning what works, what doesn't. You know what I mean?
Taking action is a skill.
Yeah.
And you learned that it wasn't efficient because you did that.
Exactly. Otherwise, I might have done it forever, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I would have done it on weekends forever if I didn't learn that it's actually not the best way to do it. Yeah. And then that allowed me to steer my time and energy towards something more productive.
Mm. Yeah.
There's a book called Ready, Aim, Fire, and basically a quick synopsis of that is that you shoot first and then you adjust your aim. You don't keep like calculating and theorizing where is best to aim. You don't keep aiming and try to get it perfect when you shoot. You shoot first and then you adjust it.
It's kind of like where you're learning how to shoot a bow, right? You can always keep learning, how does the bow work? What is the material? How should I pull it? What is the best bow to buy? What are the best arrows to buy? What is the best environment to shoot it in? But you won't actually know how to shoot a bow until you actually shoot a bow, right?
Yeah.
So it's mental masturbation. It's just overthinking. And you can always recorrect as you take the first shot. You could, I aimed a bit too left. Okay, let's aim a bit right. Okay, I aimed too much right. Let's aim a bit left. And you're constantly recorrecting and recorrecting until you find the sweet spot. And it's very easy to consume information because there's an abundance of YouTube videos and stuff like that. But you probably already know what to do. If you want to get fit, you know that you should just go to the gym. If you want to lose a bit of weight, you know you should do cardio, go for a run, 10 minutes there, 10 minutes back. If you want to make more money, you know you should get a job. If you don't have a job, get a job or find a way to enter a sales position or find a way, some sort of way that you can earn a living. You can, you know, sell something.
Get two jobs, man.
Anything.
Do something, you know?
Yup. You probably already know what to do. So it's a lot of realignment. And once you take the action and then you face a problem, then you can learn specific knowledge about that problem that you need to overcome. Maybe it's a lack of leads. Maybe it's lack of traffic. Maybe you don't know how to make content. Maybe you don't know how to speak in a way which engages people. So as you take action and you learn, and as you go, you're able to actually find the questions that you need to ask in order to solve the problems that come up. Because the thing is, you're trying to learn about step five before you even took step one.
Yeah,
you don't even know what step five. Step five could be something else completely different. Like you're learning about, let's say you haven't even, you don't even do sale calls, but you're learning sales. Like, oh, I'm just going to buy the sales course and learn sales before I do sales. No, you get into a sales job, then you learn sales. You don't learn, then start. You start, then learn.
Start, then learn.
Exactly.
It's just learning on the job.
Yeah.
Tradies say it all the time. I believe in learning on the job.
Yeah, exactly.
That's how they teach your apprentices, and that's how you get a master tradesman.
Even those people, they have the right mentality about it. Well, you have to start,
yeah.
Then learn, and then you can always like have the information afterwards, because that's basically it, bro.
Yeah. Like people who are really unfit, and they're trying to work out, oh, I don't know what the best workout routine is. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But they're not going to the gym consistently, so how the fuck are you going to figure it out? Yeah. You know what I mean?
For sure.
I actually know a lot of people like that from school. Oh, bro, I want to go gym, but I just don't know what exercise to do, what day. My routine's all mixed up, and, well, I guess you're just going to fail then. You know what I mean? You need to get in there.
Explain your business and what you do, if you don't mind.
Yeah, sure. I buy and sell cars, and I help people buy and sell cars, and now I teach people how to buy and sell cars. So I did a whole year in the car sales business as a trainee salesman. So you do 6 months as a trainee and then you're on the big money, which it's not really that big, but it's bigger than an average job. I wasn't buying cars going out and buying, but people would bring me their cars and I would evaluate them and buy them on the spot. And I would sell new cars, new Fords, new Mitsubishis and used cars on a big lot in Mandurah. But yeah, I went into that job knowing absolutely nothing. I knew nothing. Because before that, I was just working at a golf course and I would just talk to people. My practice to get good at sales was talk to old people, the old golfers,
yeah.
Old rich golfers, and just have a good talk to them. Yeah. That's how I'd, you know?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
I did that. I realized, like, fuck, I got to get into a better job. And I was like, I'm going to do car sales because I know there's a big yard right next to me. It's highly, like, sociable. The interactions are scary in the beginning. And I'm like, that's what I'm bad at. So I was like, that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Because I identified my weakness. I was like, I'm terrible at talking to people.
Yeah.
I was a nervous, shy little kid. I was skinny and broke. You know what I mean? So I was like, this is what I got to fix. This is my main weakness. So I started talking to oldies. Got good at talking to the oldies because they're easy. You know, they'll talk to anyone. And then from there, I went and just did interviews in Mandurah. Sat down with the first guy. He loved me, but not enough to call me back the same day. I went to the second yard, which was actually the better yard to work in probably. And the manager, after I talked to him for a while, got an interview on the spot and he said, don't go anywhere else, I want you to go straight home. Because, I don't know, maybe there's a shortage of work, maybe they're looking for trainees. It turned out they were, so that was good. Got in there, knew nothing. Like, answering the phone was the scariest thing ever. Like, man, I had sweat dripping down my fucking forehead first time I was answering the phone. And then they were like, you need to be better on the phone. They got me to cold call. And I did like 50 to 100 cold calls a day to random strangers and it was terrifying. But putting yourself in that uncomfortable position is where you learn, right? Discomfort equals growth. So yeah, I did that. After doing that for a while, I noticed how much money was moving and I decided to do it my own. So now I've got the ABN set up, got a dealer certificate, all that stuff running, and now I figured out how to do it on my own. And it's going pretty good and I'm moving into teaching people now. Yeah. But yeah, it's good fun. Sales are awesome. Maybe I'll teach sales one day as well. I don't know. Go Australian Andy Elliott.
What's your Instagram? Put in the plug.
Oh, it's Will M. Drew. I guess you'll put it somewhere.
If you guys want to learn about car flipping, this guy's a man when it comes to car flipping. He knows how to diagnose, like how to see the cars, whether it's a right fit, you know, how to resell it for higher prices. Like this guy knows the fucking, yeah, location finding, like looking it up on Facebook Marketplace, all these things. He knows everything about it. So follow him on Instagram if you want to know car flipping, because this shit, there's a lot of money in that. If you like cars, you like flipping, you're into sales, you want to improve your social skills, this is definitely like a good fucking job or good fucking like business model to start doing right now. If you guys want to learn how to build a social circle, like right here, I can't lie, you know, Will's here, we got Alex here.
There's like 20 guys behind
this camera. There's like 1,000 guys behind this camera. 20. One guy's hopping over the fence. So if you guys want to build a social circle, a tribe of high value guys who are working on businesses, working on self-development, improving their business, getting better with girls, guys, social skills, sales, all these different things. If you want to build a high value tribe of people, click the link in the description. I can't lie about it because there's two high level guys right here who are working on their business. So click the link in the description if you want to learn how to build that tribe, that social circle of high quality dudes right now. Because you can either continue watching videos like this and get motivated for a bit, or you can actually do something about it and change it. You can actually take action. Like I said, time is running out, bro. Like time, I'm genuinely, it's not saying that for urgency. Like I'm genuinely believe that time is running out. So you can either keep living the same life that you're living right now. You got two paths. You can keep living the same life or you can just take the action. It's only 1 minute to sign up to the community. Put in your name, that's it. Put in your name, click the link description. It only takes 1 minute and then I'll see you in there. I can DM you, we can have a chat and it will be awesome. You can learn everything about social circle building, building your tribe and building a high value circle of guys. So if you like to do that, click the link in the description and I will see you guys in there. Peace.
And I'll say right now, before I met Darius, my social circle was quite confined. I knew a few people from school. I didn't know how to reach out to other people. I didn't know how to build a social circle at all. I had no idea. Before I met him, I was pretty isolated, to be honest. I had my girlfriend, my family, a couple mates from school. But now, since I met Darius, everything's changed. My life's improved drastically. I've got so much more information, because when you surround yourself with people that know different things, you piece it all together and suddenly you've just built all the skills required for different business models. I wouldn't be doing information teaching if it wasn't for Darius, and I wouldn't be making money that way if it wasn't for him. So sign up, it's real.
I'll say, this guy, Darius, he's actually about it. Some people teaching shit, they don't even care. They don't earn e-com, they just sell e-com courses because that's where their money is. This guy actually loves his shit. He actually does. So you can feel it in his teaching. He'll just blurt out into yapping about this shit just on the everyday. He tells everyone about it. He really loves it. So I can smell it on him. He's really the real deal. Click the link in the bio, bro. Oh, yeah, your competition's moving. Some guys right now, they're scrolling down, clicking it, and you're not.
Be that guy that's gonna click the link. Learn these systems on how to build that high value tribe and change your life, because like, you are the average of the five people you hang around. I know it's very cliche, like, oh, you're the average of five people hanging around, but it is genuinely true. If you are around killers, if you're around people that are locked in, you are automatically gonna get locked in, without any joke. So click the link in the description and I will see you in there. Peace.